He made a promise to my mother to be there for me and took a vow from that day to his last breath. From day one when I arrived on earth, I've had a place over to heaven in Godfrey's house. There was a lot of transition in how I end up at the house. Grandma had just transitioned, April had Amber, Rose in college, Justin in sports. My mama was doing her own thing, and Helen said, if anything were to happen to me, Grandma would turn over in her grave. There was a family meeting, and Helen took me in. She didn't ask Godfrey. Godfrey kept a stable roof over our heads, food in our house, and the bills paid. Although everyone knew Helen kept an open door for anyone to come in, it was still serving as a safe haven for me and our family. Godfrey was a provider and worked all the time, whether it be with the police department, Dupree, at the Dome, photography, or even volunteering. Godfrey made it his business to still make time to do things that he enjoyed, such as family, racquetball, the Mill Center, numerous community bands and choirs, or even with the Howard alumni activities. At church, I was amazed at how many hats he actually wore in a single service. I would watch Godfrey as he went from ushering, serving communion, singing in the choir, playing in the ensemble, and that's not just for one service, but for both. Godfrey had a love for music, as all of us do. Lately, I would play my music, and he would listen to the words and say, oh, I like it. Since my mother's transition on Halloween of last year, I've been going out more doing karaoke as a measure of self-care to get out of the house and actually start enjoying life. Godfrey talked about how he wanted to see me and my friend Chris perform after seeing one of our performances on Facebook. In the last few weeks, when I would ask if he wanted to come, he would talk about how tired he was and declined to go. So when I would stop by the house from time to time and play songs, and we would listen to them in the room. Many times, when we would be in the car, whether it be appointments, lunch dates, family gatherings, or simply running errands. One day, I was talking to him in the room, and we were listening to Reckless Love, the Ezra Holton version, which is my favorite because it's more soulful. The song talks about how you've been so good to me, so kind to me. The overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. It chases me down, fights till I'm found, and leaves the 99. I couldn't earn it, I don't deserve it, yet you still give yourself away. There is no shadow you won't light up, no mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. No wall you won't kick down, no lie you won't tear down, coming after me. Godfrey had a love just as strong. Godfrey said if he loved a song, he would try to learn to play it on his tuba. Last time that he was here with us, I played it for him. Godfrey loved family and made sure that you feel welcome. He was a peacekeeper, a waymaker, a listening ear when he needed it. Godfrey was truly light in darkness for many reasons, which I won't elaborate on because I could be here all day from my own experiences as well as those who really knew him. I noticed a change in him last October when he got lost coming to have communion with me, my mama, and Pete before her transition to being here. The following month, he had a wreck and relied on us to transport him versus going and coming as he pleased. Godfrey's life was a sermon, and he lived a godly walk while here on earth. Godfrey, thank you for loving and accepting me into your home, heart, and family union. Thank you for always making me feel welcome and including me as one of your children. In closing, I just want to talk about Godfrey real quick. So, Brub had his own line, and it had a different ring to the house phone. I would answer the phone and say, Godfrey, telephone. After a few times of both of them answering the call, Godfrey said, you can just call me Dad to cut down on confusion. I thanked him and for the offer and started calling Godfrey Jr. Brub, which is what our parents and older family would call him. But it's fitting, because he's always treated me like his little sister, because me and Justin are close in age. I want to bring awareness of paying attention to warning signs of your loved ones. Watch for changes, whether it be medical issues, diet, mental status, etc. If possible, accompany them to doctor's appointments so you know what's going on and that you can also advocate for them. There is a time for everything, and I want to just leave with scripture, which is Ecclesiastes 3:1-3. There's a time for everything, and a season for every activity under the heavens. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to search and a time to give up. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. May God continue to bless us all. May he shine his face upon us. Give us peace that surpasses all understanding. May he continue to bless us indeed and enlarge our territory. Thank you for your mercy, grace, and favor. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, it is in Jesus' name we ask these things. Amen. Amen.
Let me put these glasses on.